Shalom, shalom. Shalom. Hear me all right?
Shalom, shalom. All right.
Shalom, Yosef.
Shalom, Ben. Can you hear me?
Come on. All right. Let me get my camera working over here.
All right. All praise to the Most High.
There we go.
All right. What's going on, brother?
Hey, man, you know, another day, another surviving this captivity, you know, and, you know, all praise to the Most High that we have another day to serve him. So,
bro, shalom to everybody watching, everybody that's going to watch. Shalom, you're in for a good one. So real quick, let me just do a little quick introduction. This is the brother Bam Laz from No Cap, Nathali brother. So I asked the brother to come on and give a breakdown of his tribe. Since we did an Ephraim breakdown, I felt it was only right that, you know, we start letting other brothers from other tribes do their breakdown on this channel, you know? So hopefully we can get other brothers from other tribes to come and do their breakdown. And next thing you know, we have a whole 12 tribe breakdown on this channel. That's the goal. That's the plan. Because it's not only Ephraim and Judah. You know what I'm saying? There's 10 other tribes. So each tribe gotta, you know, show their breakdown and represent for their tribe and show the people. So I figured what best way to do it than this right here, you know? Starting with Ephraim, because we did Ephraim already, and now the brother's willing to come on and do a breakdown. So I'm going to leave everything up to you. If you want me to read for you, all you have to do is just call out the scripture and I'll get it for you and I'll read it. Other than that, brother, you have the floor and go ahead, brother.
Appreciate you, Ak. Appreciate you, man. Hey, man, salute to you, King. I know we've known each other for quite a few years, man. And, you know, you and I always dialogue, man. So it's good to see you doing what you're doing, King. So Most High keep blessing you and keep you and your family, Ak. And let's do the work, man. You know what I'm saying?
I'm doing what I can.
No. Hey, Ephraim going to push the people, man. Yeah. All right? Ephraim going to push the people. So, hey, man, it's good to see you, Ak, for real, man. So I appreciate you having me on your platform and, you know, breaking down my tribe. You know, typically I get a lot of questions, right? Especially when soldiers are up for their, I guess, soldiers test, you know, because there ain't too many Nephtalis out. But I'll get like my inbox, like every now and then will be like, hey, Ak, what about this? What about that? And then I get all these questions asking about my tribe. So, you know, it's a good thing that we can, you know, have something like this or a platform where, you know, somebody could refer to a tribe, especially a tribe that, you know, we don't necessarily get seen too much.
Right.
You know, and don't really understand. And quite honestly, you know, to be honest, you know, I've heard some breakdowns before. And, we could do a little bit better, Yasharala. That's all I got to say. You know, my main focus has always been, you know, waking up all 12 tribes, man, as through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. But it's good to focus, you know, sometimes on one tribe. So, you know, definitely, you know, again, salute to you, King, and, you know, definitely do it. But just a quick introduction for myself. You know, like I said, you know, my name is Bam Laz from No Cap, Nations of Kings and Priests, located in Tampa, Florida. We're going to do a quick breakdown for you. The main thing that we're going to be covering is prophecy and location, right? And then we're going to grab some attributes within the tribe, because that is extremely important, right? I do want to make a couple of disclaimers before we get into it. You know, we do understand that the 12 tribes of Israel are scattered in the four corners of the earth. However, the majority of us would be in the bulk in the last days in the Western Hemisphere. We're gonna grab some information on that as well. And then there's a reason why we're gonna be in the Western Hemisphere. And then the majority of a bulk of us woken up in there together, right? Together, woken up so that we can also be delivered together, right? Which is, again, something that's prophecy and something I'm going to get into. I've met brothers, in the islands that are Israelites, but I do not necessarily hone into just one tribe is, you know, out there in the islands. We don't subscribe to that.
Right. Real quick, because you said that, and that's like Puerto Rico. It would be asinine for anyone who's Ephraimite or claim Ephraimite to say that only Ephraim is on that island. We know Judah is heavy on that island, and through history, we also know that there's some Issachars on that island.
Gone.
It would be asinine to say that one tribe is on one region, you know?
Right. Hey, Aga, if I could just land back what you're saying, you know, last year we went to Puerto Rico, you know, because that was, you know, Ephraim is an integral part in us, you know, waking up and being delivered, because we understand that last times, you know, Ephraim's going to be woken up. So we went to Puerto Rico and went to La Isla, you know, in the middle of all this madness. And, you know, we literally got off the plane and said and asked, hey, where is the hood? You know, where is the where nobody goes? Where is it? They said Luisa.
Yeah.
Right. If anybody know where Luisa is. Hey, I didn't know what Luisa, but I said, where is it? They're like, what do you mean? They're like, where's the address? You don't want to go there. What are you going to do? We went there to preach the word.
Right.
And when we over there, we met Benjamite brothers.
Mm-hmm.
We met Levites.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And Judites.
Mm-hmm.
Right. They understood. Right. So, Khan, what you're saying is absolutely 100%. You know, facts, and I can attest and witness to that.
Yeah.
Because we actually went over there and actually, you know, witnessed it ourselves. A lot of brothers like to say, well, you know what, it's not this, it's not that. Well, look, bro, it's a little more complicated, but then again, when we are identifying the people and talking to them, and actually we were able to sit down and speak to them, they understood who they were.
Yeah.
You know?
History, as long as you understand history, then you understand who the people are that are there. It doesn't take a rocket science to understand who's there and who's not. You even got Edomites there. I mean, you got Ammon there. There's a lot of people over there. But Louisa got a deep history dating back to 1619. Louisa, the people of Louisa, you know, Negro onlys would try to say that Louisa, the people from Louisa, been there from the beginning with the Tainos, but that's not the case. Many inhabitants of Louisa came from 1619. That's facts.
Facts.
Yes, yeah, facts. That's facts. And any Puerto Rican that wants to deny that, then they need to do their own history of their own island, because that's just facts too. So. But I mean, it is what it is, bro. It is what it is.
Hey, man, like the scripture says, all shall be revealed at the end of the day, you know, and we're here to wake up our people. So, you know, again, salute King. And guess what? We're going back to Puerto Rico. We're going to actually meet up with the Taino Nation out there. We've been speaking to them. They have agreed to sit down and speak with us.
Wow.
And they already heard about, you know, basically, you know, what we want to talk about. So we're going to have a discussion with them. So salute to the, you know, the brother here in Tampa who actually, you know, connected us together. So we're going to go back there, man. So, you know,
that's y'all heavy. Stay tuned, man. That's heavy, man. That's heavy. Huh? That's real heavy.
Yeah, yeah. How I will it, man. We'll you know, whatever, film it or record it. But I would really love to get them, you know, to understand because, hey, we live in last days, man. You know?
Yeah, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh,
about
yeah.
Time we wake up, man, and oh, yeah. Who we are, man, you know, so.
Oh, yeah.
But definitely want to dig into the. I did a little presentation, King. So I don't know if you can let me share my screen.
Yeah. Go ahead and try to do it. This is my first time doing this live stuff.
Comic-Con. Yep, I got it. Okay.
Okay. I want to see if I could remove myself from here or give you the full screen. And I'm not too sure.
Can you see my screen right now?
Yeah, I can see. Yeah, it's the screen that you're sharing now.
No, okay. Hold on.
Hold up. I see it now.
Okay, Con.
There you go.
Okay, perfect.
There you go.
All right, appreciate it. So, you know, we did a little, you know, just something put together for the tribe of Neftali. And, you know, they're, you know, when you're talking about a tribe, it is so, you can get so in depth with it, especially since the, you know, the actual, you know, scriptures, man, they're spiritual. And, you know, for those who have an ear, let them hear and understand, you know, but there's so much, you know, deepness to the breakdowns of our tribes, you know. So what we're going to focus on today is prophecy breakdown on the location of Neftali in the last days. Right. So, you know, and again, that those are the integral parts of how we can identify who they really are, you know. So let me see here. All right, so just a quick little breakdown, you know, who Neftali is in Hebrew. Neftali, right, meaning my struggle, right, was the northmost, right, of the 12 tribes of Israel. What does that mean? That means a location in Israel. We had well, the northernmost parts in Israel, in our land, right? It was one of the lost 10 tribes, right? And this is Genesis chapter 30 and verse 8. And the reason why we were called Neftali, it says, and Rachel said, with great wrestling have I wrestled with my sister, and I have prevailed, and she called his name Neftali, right? Because, you know, Rachel did struggle, you know, with our foremother, you know, to have, you know, our have us, you know, and that was part about building a nation, right? So she said, wrestle. So Neftali was our name, right? So from there, just a little bit of the prophecy when it comes to Neftali. And this is going to be integral in the actual finding out where he is and where we are today. Okay. So we're going to start off with Genesis 49 and verse 1. Now, when we talk about breakdowns and when we're, you know, everybody likes to talk about the chart and, you know, the chart, you know, the chart's false, but the chart's prophecy, right? And when we're referencing Genesis 49, we always have to reference chapter or verse 1. And that is extremely important. Why? It'll say it. It says Genesis 49 and verse 1. It says, and Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourselves together, that I may tell you which shall befall you in the last days. You see that? So an integral part of what will happen in the last days, right? Why? Because he's gonna be prophesying to us on his deathbed is gonna be prophesied for us to happen in our last days. And here you have Judah, right? Where it talks about Shiloh, you know, and here you have Zebulon's location, right? And here you have Simeon and Levi being together. So again, we have to look at this as where are they in the last days? And Yasharallah, we live in last days today. Okay. So verse 21, right? It says, Naphtali is a hind let loose. He giveth goodly words, right? Also Deuteronomy 33:23. It says, and Naphtali, he said, O Naphtali, satisfied with favor and full of the blessing of the Lord, possesses thou the west and the south. Now I put now as you can see on the right hand side of your screen, I put the actual map of Israel where we were. Now you can see Naphtali and Asher were always together, right? Or always beside each other. Even at war, we were next to each other, you know. But this depicts us at being what? As far north as can be. Now, when we're looking at Deuteronomy 33:23 and what Moses prophesied to us, he gave us a specific location where we're going to be. Okay. And he said, blessing of the Lord, possesses thou the west and the south. Okay. So for those of y'all taking notes, Genesis 49 verse 1, Genesis 49 and 21, and Deuteronomy 33:23. And we're going to actually reference these and answer these. Okay. As we move along in this slide. All right. So now, oops, where'd I go? There I go. All right, sorry, my bad. So now, when we look at direction, right? When we say that Naphtali is Chile and Argentina, Chile and Argentina are the southwest most points to where Israel was located at, right? There is no more south point and no more west point when it comes to Chile and Argentina. You would have to pass that whole continent to say that they're not there. You can't do that. You got to look at the continent where it's looking at, right? So coincidentally, and not coincidentally, but also in the divine art of the Most High, right? You look at Chile and Argentina. Chile, right? Chile is a Hebrew word, right? Now in our tongue, and not in the modern day Hebrew, it is Chile is Tazalaya, right? Now Tazalaya means it's actually a name, right? And you can find that in Genesis. It's like a Genesis 4:19, right? Now if you look at the actual word itself in translation, right? And I'll put some arrows on the first screen, right? Where it's Chile and then translated into the modern Hebrew, right? Then you got the second slide, which is in the blue letter, all right, from that reference in Genesis, right? Then we see definition. Right. So definition outline says to be or to become grow dark. Right. To become grow dark, to shadow. Definition, a primitive root word, right? So now this is the root word of the actual word. And look what's highlighted here. It's twilight. Now, I don't know if you can actually see the definition of twilight here, but as we go deeper into that word, what does twilight actually mean? So one of the definitions of twilight is sunset, right? So now watch this. So now, like we said, the bottom point south from Israel and west, like it said in Deuteronomy 33 and 23, right? It said, Naphtali, he's satisfied with favor, right? And with the blessings of the Lord, possesses thou the west and the south. So the farthest point south and the farthest point west is pointing directly at Argentina and Chile.
Oof.
Chile itself means twilight, right? Now, where does the sun set, right? Regardless of whether you are in the northern hemisphere. Now, this is something that I grabbed, right? It says, regardless whether you are in the northern or southern hemisphere, the sun will always rise in the east and set in the west. All right. Hey, Yasop, can you do me a favor? Grab me. Let's go into 2nd Ezra. Baba Kasha. I couldn't fit 2nd Ezra in here.
What chapter and verse?
We'll do 2nd Ezra, the 13th chapter. We'll start at verse 40 to 46.
13, 40 to 46. Let me know when you need me to start reading.
Okay, let me finish this here. And it says, so it sets in the west. So now, whether you want to talk, you know, nobody can get away geographically. You got south, west, east, north, okay? You got direction. We know that the sun itself rises in the east and sets in the west. These are our directions, okay? So now this is, you can't get away with the direction of where they're going to be located at. However, 2nd Ezra 13 does talk about, you know, where we're going to, where are we going, and the navigation of the 10 tribes. So go ahead, Yasef, if you can, go ahead and start out at verse 40, Baba Kasha.
All right. This is 2nd Ezra chapter 13, verse 40. And this is on those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea, the king whom Salmanasar, the king of Assyria, led away captive, and he carried them over the waters. And so came they into another land.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 41. But they took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt.
Now, on time and history, you're looking at 539, 540 BC. Okay. Now, I didn't put this on this slide, but you can actually look into the rocks in Brazil. Now, these are ancient Phoenician rocks in Brazil that depict a writing on it, Phoenician writing that dates back to 540 plus BC, right? And they say that we came from Canaan from the east. Okay. And now, whether we want to argue about, you know, whether we came into the water, whether Azarus is America, there are too many signs pointing at the west, which we'll get a little bit into. But go ahead, continue reading.
All right, verse 42. That they might there keep their statues, which they never kept in their own land.
So stop right there, real quick. I wanted to grab that because that there, right? So now the 10 tribes, could they have scattered into different parts? When we were enslaved by the colonizers, of course, we also did what? We also moved into different locations, right? Absolutely. But the point was for us to stay in the land that we landed on, right? or that we discovered the new land where never mankind dwelt, and keep the statutes and laws and commandments there. Okay? So go ahead, keep reading.
Verse 43. And they entered into Euphrates by the narrow passages of the river.
Uh-huh.
Verse 44. For the Most High then showed signs for them, and hell stood the flood till they were passed over.
Right.
Verse 45. For through that country there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half.
So now, real quick, stop there, Yasser. I'm going to say this. You can walk from Israel down to almost South Africa, and it will take you less than a year. Okay? But if you were to travel from where we know the Euphrates is at, all the way down, right, into America or the Americas, it will take you around that time.
Khan, real quick, just to add in, I did a Northern Kingdom video and a couple of years back, and I brought out this movie that they had there with Christopher Columbus. And in Christopher Columbus, he even said that going the opposite direction from Spain around Africa into India would be about a year to a year and a half. So if you go the opposite direction from Israel around Africa into Americas, that's about a year and a half.
There you go. Khan. And again, these are just facts, right?
Right.
We got all this information now that we can refer to and know, but we're going to, we got some headbangers after, you know, oh, we got some headbangers, but go ahead, King.
And the same region is called Arsareth, verse 46. Oh, also that place Arsareth in if you go to the Jewish encyclopedia, that place Arsareth, Columbus identified that with the Americas,
right?
Where he got from Second Esdras, which we where
he got
right
from
now.
Second Esdras, right? Stealing it from us and taking credit for it, right?
Right. Verse 46. Then dwelt they there unto the latter time. And
so
now,
then dwelt they there, where? Azarus, right?
Mm-hmm.
Into the latter times. Why? Read.
And now when they shall begin to come.
That is the point, right? Is we're going to be here in the latter, the bulk of us, right, are going to be here in the West, right? And we're going to, you know, gather ourselves together, wake up to who we are, understand that the customs, traditions, things that we encountered, this is us identifying with the curses, identifying to the customs, identifying to the archaeology, right? Northern Kingdom, you make up the bulk of Israel. I'm going to repeat that. You make up the bulk of Israel. You need to wake up to who you are. And we need to get popping, man. Straight up. You know? Now, here's some references to also us being in the West, right? This is Baruch chapter 4 and verse 37. If you want to grab that, Yasser, since you're in the Apocrypha.
Yeah, I got it. This is verse 37 of Baruch chapter 4 that says, "Lo, thy sons come, whom thou sentest away. They come gathered together."
Gathered together, right? From where?
From the east.
Uh-huh.
To the west.
To the where?
To the west.
You see that? So now we again, this is geographical, okay? And where we're going to be, this goes with Second Esdras. Now, Israel's where? East. The continent of Africa is where? East. Right? Not saying we don't have brothers in Africa. We got brothers in Africa. Absolutely. I know personal brothers and elders that I have in Africa today. But we also got brothers in Turkey. And I'm going to tell you this. We also got brothers in India. Okay? However, the majority and bulk of us will be here in these latter days, right? So now here's another one that that we get as well, which is Hosea chapter 11 and verse 10. If you want to grab that, Yasser, and this is This is one that we understand that is only talking about Ephraim, right? So when you read this whole chapter and it's referring to Ephraim as the 10 tribes of Israel, but it's going down the line this whole chapter, but there's something very distinct here, right? When we're reading Hosea 11 and verse 10, so go ahead and grab that, King.
Okay. The book of Hosea, chapter 11 and verse 10, and it says, they shall walk after the Lord.
Well, now this is talking about Ephraim, meaning we're going to wake up to who we are and walk after the Lord. All right, read.
They shall walk after the Lord. He shall roar like a lion.
Right.
When he shall roar, then the children shall tremble from the west.
From where?
From the west.
It's not talking about south. It's not talking about north. It's not talking about east. The only word that you see here is west. Now, this is future condemnation. How do we know that? Because it says they shall walk after the Lord. And who is the Lord here? The Lord is Yahawashi HaMashiach. How do we know that? Because he is the lion that roars from the tribe of Judah. You read that in John, the 10th chapter, where he talks about, I also have another fold, I also have another sheep, not of this fold. Who is that fold? The northern kingdom of Israel, right? And check this out. And then when he talks about the prodigal son, northern kingdom is the prodigal son. That's the parable of Judah is the son that stayed. The prodigal son is us, northern kingdom, who went after idolatry and left our inheritance. Right? We did that when we left. And that's why we went into slavery. We forgot our true identity. We started worshiping idols. I mean, the majority of us grew up in Catholicism, man. You know, and now thinking back, we're like, damn, man, how do we, you know, the Bible says everything contrary to what Catholicism is. You know? So, you know, again, us identifying, waking up to who we are, and we see the lion from the tribe of Judah waking up, and when he shall roar, that roar is what? That roar is the word going out, right? And where we're going to hear that word? From the west. Con? So now we have direction. Now we have identification. So now I'm going to just go into, I just have two references from this book, but there are so many. And I'm sure, yes, there's so many you can bring out as well, but there is so many references in books that we can provide you with that say who you are, especially the first colonizers who came and saw us. You know, there's so many books. But just to kind of drive home the book references on the part of the West, right? So now watch this. So this is from The Star in the West, all right, page 110, right? And it reads, the Southern Indians, which who are they speaking about, the Southern Indians? Us, right? The natives from the South, right? The Southern Indians also have a tradition among them which they believe that in old time their ancestors lived beyond the great river, and 9 parts of their nation out of 10 passed over the river, but the remainder refused and stayed behind.
Oof.
You see that? So why do you know that goes in perfectly with the scriptures. We see in Matthew 4, the Asherite prophetess, you know, we see Tobit, right, in the book of Ezra, where he's still in Nineveh, right? We see still have remnants of Northern Kingdom that are out there, but them also believing a great river, right? Now here's another part. This is also from the Star in the West, right? Page 111 and 110. And it reads, the Indian informed him. Now, this is, again, talking about the Southern Indian, that one of their ancient traditions was that a great while ago, they had a common father who lived toward the rising of the sun, right? Now, where's the rising of the sun? The east, right? He governed the whole world, that all the, and this is what he said, this is not my words, the words of the book. He says that all the white people's heads were under his feet, that he had 12 sons by whom he administered his government, that his authority was derived from a great spirit by virtue of some special gift from him, that the 12 sons behaved very bad and tyrannized over the people, abusing their power with great degree, so as offended the great spirit exceedingly, that he, being thus angry with them, suffered the white people to induce spirituous liquors among them, made them drunk, stole their special gift of the great spirit from them, and by the means of usurped the power over them. And ever since, the Indians' heads were under the white people's feet, but that they also had a tradition that the time would come when the Indians would reign the gift of the great spirit from the people, and with it their ancient power, when the white people's heads would be under the Indians' feet.
Khan, that's scripture. That's biblical scripture right there.
That's Isaiah 49, Isaiah 60.
Yes, I mean, Isaiah 60.
So many. It's crazy, man.
But that's Isaiah 63 and everything. That's
that ain't my words, man. That's the book, you know. Right.
But you see, I think, sorry, Salakia. I think the issue that a lot of people tend to always have is they don't know history and they don't know scripture. So when they see history in these books, they can't tie it to the scriptures because they don't know scripture. But if they knew scripture, they would see it. When they would see these words and hear these words, they would be like, yo, that's biblical. Just like right. I did, because I you know, we understand scripture. So when you was reading that, I'm like, bro, that's prophecy.
Scripture.
Right, yeah, man. Like, oh, snap, man. But go ahead, man. Go ahead.
Nah, you know, and yeah, so they all ain't gonna get it, man. we understand that, man. They all ain't gonna get it. Some will reject it, you know. But ultimately, we know we're the chosen people, Yasharala. And you know, we just gotta move forward, man, and continue to do the work, man, for our people. It's a great sacrifice, but at the same time, we know that without a great sacrifice, we're not gonna make it into the kingdom. So you know, me being a Neptali, I've probably met, and I say close to my 10 years in this truth, I would say maybe two Neptalis face to face that actually knew they were Neptali. You know, it's sad, man. You know, but ultimately, you know, that's you know, what I have to go through. But I do plan, Yahweh willing, if I'm still alive and kicking in this generation, to go maybe go out there, you know, and test it out in the battlefield, you know, over there in South America. So we'll see.
Con,
right now it's Ephraim. We gotta wake up Ephraim. You know what I'm saying?
Gotta wake up all 12 tribes, brother. All 12.
No,
tribes.
No, most definitely. But we know that Ephraim is extremely important, man. You know, and honestly, man, like we were out there, like they came up to us in Louisa, and they were hugging us, man, straight up. You had drug dealers who we were teaching like right in front of, with big you know, big guns on them. You know what I mean? and they were probably the most welcome to us, and we felt like we were intruding in their space, but they knew that this was the truth. And
but you know, to be honest, man, our people, they will stop and listen because they're zealous for the word. You know what I'm saying? They right. might lack the knowledge, but they are zealous for the word. It's just, you know, I think a lot of us, we don't, like, I hit the streets recently, and I could be honest with you, a lot of us don't know how to articulate ourselves towards people that don't have knowledge towards the scriptures. And that's the problem, the communication.
Right.
So need right. to work on that.
Yeah, Con. And you know, like a great fisherman, we have to know how to fish.
Mm.
You know, you know, when we, it's just like fishing, man. You go to a certain area, you may need different bait. You may need, you know, you may need to just wait a little bit, be patient.
Right.
One thing that we know for sure, the word does not go void. You know what I'm saying? You know, we've been on the street in the same spot for I would say in this spot for maybe about 4 years. And, you know, we've had brothers come up to us and say, man, I've listened to y'all for years. I just have never approached y'all, but I know this is the truth, you know? And that was very touching because we were like, damn, you know, like this is, you know, the word will never go out void, like the Lord says, you know? So I'll pray to see how Bashimi Al-Shai for that, man, you know? But then we know that they're going to be rebellious as well. So,
you right, know, right, we, right, right.
Deal with the bad as well, you know, but maybe you and I will go out to Puerto Rico, man, and get it
oh,
in.
Oh, man, that would be a blessing for real. That would be.
And you know, the Taino thing is, I mean, that's going to be great. We actually are also trying to get in contact with the El Doctor Herrera, I think he is, the one who found the 800.
The stones in Puerto Rico. Yeah.
So, you know, we, again, we're making moves, Yasharada, and you know,
it's, you know,
man.
I've been, so the 800 stones, Hebrew inscripted stones that were found in Puerto Rico. I've been wanting to do a class on that since I learned about it. But I'm not going to do a class on that until I speak to the Hebrew university that so-called took them into their possession.
Right. They did. Yeah,
I want to speak to somebody from this university, and I've been meaning to like do my extensive research and extensive homework on these stones, and the Hebrew university that so-called Jewish university that obtained these stones afterwards. So, you guys, when I do find that, you guys will be the first ones to know, because I'm definitely gonna do a video on that.
Con, that's dope, man. We'll be waiting, man. Whatever information I can give you, let me know. I mean, we're gonna try and you know, get some information from the el doctor, you know, who actually you know, discovered them or translated them. So
yeah, maybe he could give you the so-called Jewish university that took it.
Con,
because then we could contact them and see more information about them. You know what I'm saying? Because
that's right. That's right.
They them devils, man, and they like to, you know, they like to do a lot of grimy stuff. But Ak, I want you to finish that last slide or those last two slides that you have there.
So then we can continue talking.
Comic-Con.
So you see, Yasharala, we got book references, obviously, of you know, directional, right? Of where we came and speaking about, you know, us, you know, the natives in the you know, the southern point of the continent of South America, understanding that we came from the West, right? You know, obviously, you know, considered our name Mapuche, right? Translate to the people of the earth, right? You could also, you know, look at that as, you know, Genesis, you know, 2 and 7, you know, as we were created from the dust of the earth, you know. So, you know, that's kind of where our name comes from. Now, we have our own language. I didn't have time to actually go into the alphabet, but the alphabet is extremely identical to Hebrew. I mean, it is extremely identical. But we do have a celebration, a feast day, right? Which you can find that we would celebrate it between our beginning of harvest day, right? And this is called Wanapu Trumaktu, right? It's a Mapuche celebration of the return of the sun, and it's sometimes called the Mapuche New Year. Now, it is identical to Passover, and as a matter of fact, it is a rendition of Passover, right? And everything from the sacrificing of an animal, of a clean animal, and everything to the actual altar, to priests, right? This gentleman that you see on your screen, all right, his name is Felix. He is actually what you call a protester for our people in Chile and Argentina, you know, because obviously, like all of us, we're going through it, man. You know, we're going through the curses. They're taking our land. They're stealing our children. You know, I'll go through some information on that as well, because it's important for us to also identify ourselves through Deuteronomy 28, who obviously identifies who the Israelites are in the last days. But you know, obviously they have a Passover or a feast day that is extremely similar to Passover and their New Year. And when during their feast day in March, April, or in May. So depending on where the sun lands in the southern hemisphere, right? So quick observation, it says the Mapuches or Anahuas started to penetrate the area coming from Chile and gradually separated around Patagonia and the Argentinian Pampas. Now, these are extremely large lands. Argentina and Chile are, you know, probably one of the most fertile lands that you can get. You have everything from rainforests to mountains, the Andes, to deserts, to beaches, to La Tierra del Fuego. Tierra del Fuego is one of the most inhospitable areas that you can actually live in, you know, but we actually live there and we thrive there until colonization, of course, right? But from a distance, their dwellings and their nomad behavior, which let them become adapted to the new territory. So, you know, what we did and being nomadic, you know, is a prophecy, right? And what is that prophecy? That prophecy is that, you know, we shall be a hind let loose. Now, here you go. Now, again, we look at the scriptures being spiritual. We look at the scriptures also being prophecy. Now, this is no coincidence here, man. But, you know, Genesis 49 and 21, Naphtali is a hind let loose. He giveth goodly words. Naphtali, a hind, a deer. What is the national animal for Chile? A deer.
There you go.
What deer? South Adrian deer, right? An endangered species of the deer. Watch this. Native to the mountains of Argentina and Chile. What are the odds of that?
Bring it out.
You know? So again, you know, when we look at, you know, our tribe and what we, you know, we look at prophecy and we look at direction, you know, you got to be looking somewhere, you know. Now, it doesn't necessarily mean that I don't advocate that, you know, Naphtali could be over here, Ephraim over here. As a matter of fact, you know, we were conversating with brothers in the Philippines, man, straight up brothers, man. Believe in Yahweh Shemiah Shai, you know, feast days, the whole nine, man. Now, you know, could they be Ephraim? Ephraim went there. You know, we have books where Ephraim was taken from Puerto Rico to, you know, Hawaii,
yes,
and the Philippines, man.
Yes, yes, you know? Yes, yes.
You know, and but again, knowing who they are, right? So again, we're not denying that Israel's not scattered, but when we're talking about one location, that's where Israel's going to be at. You could read Jeremiah, the 50th chapter and the 33rd verse, and it says that Ephraim and Judah shall be oppressed together. So you got to show me Judah and Ephraim oppressed together.
Right.
So, right. So, you know, that's the short and quick of it, of the presentation. Oof. But, you know, definitely want to share one more thing. So we have this in mind, because brothers, man, look, we suffering, man, you know, we suffering wherever we at, you know, in Israel, you know, in our captivity, right? Let me see here. Okay, can you see my screen?
I'll share it right now. Hold on. It's right there. We see it now.
Yeah, so you see, this is the regular life of what, you know, Naphtali's going through, you know? Right? Look at this. Libertad, freedom, a los presos políticos de Mapuche, right? And these are our people, man. They're struggling for their freedom in their own land. Right. Look at this. Justice, justicia. Right. Watch this picture, because this picture is powerful right here. And look at the smoke being thrown at them. I mean, again, the curses are going to come upon you in forever. Right. Look at this picture. Let's see if I can pull it up here.
Yo, you notice how there was a Hebrew words right there too, right?
So like your word. Right. Oh yeah, come on. Oh yeah, look at
that. Hebrew words right in there.
Look at this, fighting for our freedom, and till this day, man. You know, so again, man, we getting it. You know, just, you know, be cognizant of that, Yasharala. And you know, we live in last days, man. It's time for us to repent and come back to you. How about Shemi Oshai, man?
Khan, man, that was powerful.
All praise, honor, glory to you.
Oh, yeah, all praises, man. You have brought out the hind let loose at the beginning. And I was like, I hope the brother touches on that. I hope, because it was just like one little short scripture. And I'm like, man, I hope the brother touches on that. And but yeah, you did, though. And when you did, it was powerful. Like, it's the national flag. It's
the national animal.
Animal, I mean, right? Is that,
you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like if Judah had a country, and it'll be the national animal of Judah will be the lion.
Right. Like,
so, yeah, man, too many variables, man. But
yeah.
Good thing, man.
That was powerful, brother. I appreciate you coming on and doing that for the people. But yeah, I think what people we need to, like you had said earlier about Naphtali, you know, like you only met two Naphtalis in the truth, and that's bad. And so, like, any way that I can help you to reach out to any Argentinians or any Chileans, I mean, hey, brother, I'm willing to help, because like, all 12 tribes need to wake up. And what it says 12,000 from each tribe need to be sealed.
Each tribe.
So yeah, we need to make sure that we sealing these 144, right? 12,000 from each tribe. So we need work to do. Like I was telling the brother Iraq a lot that I get on here with. I told him we got a lot of work to do. A lot. All praises, you know, to the Most High for waking up Judah in massive numbers, right?
Right.
But I think it's time that Northern Kingdom gets focused on heavy, Because right. It's 12,000 from each tribe, not 144 from Judah. You understand?
That's right.
So we have to push for all 12 tribes, and Northern Kingdom needs a fire lit up their butt so they could wake up and start paying attention. So I think whatever we got to do, man, I'm with it. I'm down. You got a brother over here that's willing to help whatever you need help with, and let's get this going, man. I mean,
let's do it.
If you only seen freaking two Nephtalis in this truth, something's not right. Something's not right. So we gotta wake our people up and you know, go gung-ho for waking our people up, man. That's like Simeon. Simeon is a rare fruit in this truth too. Like there's more Gad. There's more Gad than Simeon in this. Right. You see what I'm saying? And like, not that, you know, it should be any competition, but you know, we should be waking up our people up equally and abundantly everywhere. So,
yeah, you know, I think when we read prophecy, right, we understand that the tents of Judah shall be saved first, right? And you know, look, Northern Kingdom, you know, it's so-called, you know, Hispanics and Natives, you know, y'all got to understand something. So real quick, this is Second Esdras, right? This is Second Esdras chapter 2 and verse 18, and it reads, "For thy help will I send my servants, Eli and Jeremiah, after whose counsel I have sanctified and prepared for thee 12 trees laden with diverse fruits." What does that mean? That means that we're diverse, man, you know? So, you know, where, you know, Puerto Rico got their flavor, you know, South Americans got their flavor, Issachar got their flavors, man. I love my Issachar brothers, man, straight up.
Yeah, like, I'm not gonna lie.
For real, I love them, straight up, man. I have a lot of brothers who Issachar, man, and I grew up, they're just everything, man. You know what? Ephraim, I mean, Zebulon, I mean, we just a beautiful array of nations.
Yeah, right.
We all diverse in our own way. So if, you know, we Northern Kingdom and we looking at Judah a certain way, we got to understand that we all diverse.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, unfortunately, and I'm going to speak plain. You know, when I first came in this truth, you know, I was, you know, I could have been offended with the way I was treated as a Northern Kingdom brother, right? However, you know, you got to stick to, right, what you got to focus on, which is what? Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, the truth. You got to, you know, serve in sincerity and in truth. And understand that there's no bargaining away from this book, you know? And the mission is clear, man. And, you know, we, I myself, you know, we just had a Hebrew summit, man. I got to say, there must have been 400 Hebrews, man, out there in ATL, man, in Georgia, you know. And it was a beautiful event. But I'm going to tell you this, man. I was, you know, I sat up there, me, Northern Kingdom brother, you know, next to the elders, man. You know, I'm an officer, but, you know, I sat next to them, but them seeing me up there and you know, maybe having a similarity to some of the brothers, whether you and Ephraim, whether you, you know, whatever, Zebulon, you know, it can inspire a brother and say, you know what, you know, maybe I could talk to this brother. Maybe there's something we could do to help. Let's do it, man. But the nation is growing. And it's about time for us to start waking up and doing the work, you know. And, you know, I always say this, you know, when I first came out of truth, everything made sense. Everything lined up. Everything was like, damn, you know, this is it. This is the truth.
Mm-hmm.
There was also great sorrow, Of course. I understood that the mission.
Of course.
It was a big mission that was in front of us. So, man,
I mean, the scriptures are plain. The scriptures are plain. It says, "With much knowledge comes much sorrow," because we know who we are, but the rest of our people don't. And then trying to give that knowledge to them and share with them, and when they refuse it, it becomes a burden. It becomes dreadful, and it becomes heartbroken to us, knowing that our people just are ignorant because they choose to be ignorant. But what I will tell you is that there are a lot of individuals waking up. So you might not have a lot going into camps, but you do have a lot of individuals. And I think that's why we don't see it much, because a lot of Northern Kingdoms are hesitant to go into these camps.
Like Northern Kingdom.
You know how Northern Kingdom is, right? Right. Just you know how Northern Kingdom is. But for those, my message to those that are individual as myself, that I'm not in a camp, what I could say is do your work.
Right.
You don't have to be in a camp to, no offense to the camps, but you don't have to be in a camp to do the work.
That's right.
That's facts. It don't take much to talk.
Don't look at it like you got big camps out there. You got no, man. I'm gonna tell y'all this. I was in there. I did join a very big camp. I left for many reasons, but it was just us doing the work. The work don't stop.
Right.
Keeping the law, statutes, and commandments don't stop. Keeping the faith doesn't stop. Yahweh Shai's example does not stop. You have to keep going. So whether you want to start a camp, whether you want to not be in a camp, it don't matter. You know, it don't change. So just keep
that
in mind.
You still got work to do, though, regardless.
Exactly.
Because once you know this truth, now you have a duty.
That's right.
So, and that duty is to wake your people up. So.
That's right. That's right. And if I could, man.
Bring it out. Bring it out.
Isaiah. If I could find Isaiah in here. Isaiah 45, right? 49 and verse 5. It says, and now saith the Lord who formed thee, who formed me from the womb to be his servant, right? This is your job, to bring Jacob back again. We got to identify who Jacob is to bring him back again, Khan.
Right.
If you don't know who he is, how you going to bring him back, right? Though Israel be not gathered, yet shall I be glorious in the eyes of the Lord, and my God shall be my strength, right? So, Khan, we have to, that's our job, man. We got to help bring the people together. If you want to claim a camp, whatever. If you don't, this is your job.
Right. Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. You have a duty, and your duty is to wake your people up regardless of whether you're in a camp or not. As a matter of fact, if you're not in a camp, then you really should be doing the work and going out there and waking your people up, because you're not in a camp. So you can't use the excuse like, oh, I'm in a camp. So, nah, you're not in a camp. What are you doing? What are you doing? You know what I'm saying? So
gotta go out there. Brothers tell me, hey, you know, if I was over there with you, I'll be, you know, going to camp with you, but I don't because I live whatever in casa carajo, you know? And I'm like, brother, you're the camp in casa carajo.
Hey, there you go.
Here in Tampa, there was nobody here in Tampa. I'm straight up. There were two brothers, all right, who were teaching before me, and they were the only brothers who were ever teaching, right? They still teach until this day. So all praise, honor, and glory, and I give credit, but there was nobody else. Now you got to fight for corners over here. You know what I'm saying? So, but you know what? Like Paul said, he said, whether Christ is preached, I still rejoice.
Right.
Because Christ is preached.
Right.
Because the work is going out there. So regardless of whether it's whoever, the word's getting out there. And it's not about me. It's not about my camp. It's about Yahweh Shimei Oshai.
It's about the people. It's about waking up the people. It is. I don't know. But my whole thing is for those that are not in a camp, put in the work. Put in the work. Put in the work by yourself. You don't need to be in a camp. I'm not in a camp, and I'm trying my best to do the work. So, I mean, and wake people up. And I had a girl. And anyway, never mind. But you know, this is just doing the work is a testament to your faith, believe it or not. So, if you watching videos about the truth and learning about the truth, and you believe this truth, then you should put your faith, you know, to test and go out there and put the work out. Make little flyers and pass out the flyers.
Right.
You know, do little things like that. I got a stack of flyers in my car. So whenever I get in my car and go somewhere, I could, you know, I'm starting to home in right now because I'm brand new to the area. So I'm starting to home in on where's what, who's where.
Come on.
You know what I'm saying? Right. I'm scoping things out. So as I move around through the city, I'm like, okay, see where these people are at here. I see here, you know, see.
Where you at? Right?
I'm in Houston.
Oh, con. Okay, con.
Yeah, I'm in Houston.
I got a brother out there right now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he was called to do a job actually because of the hurricane. To protect something up, but he's actually in Houston, bro. I might connect y'all, man.
He's gonna be out for a few months. Yeah, yeah. So, have me link up with him. That's what's up. Of course, heck yeah.
Ephraim, heck yeah. Brother, man. So you know,
of course, man.
Connect y'all Ephraim mics together, man.
Issachar is heavy out Issachar here.
Heavy, right? Con.
Hey, man. I never enjoyed Issachar food before until I started. And Issachar,
you get Issachar that good some, food, dog.
Yeah, they got some good food, man. Definitely, and they heavy out here, heavy.
You're gonna be spoiled, dog. You're gonna gain some weight with that food, dog.
Man, I'm trying to get some Issachar brothers to get down with me, and you know, hit them streets, cause you know, Issachar, every tribe is like this, and they don't really gravitate outside their tribe.
Right.
What I noticed, you know, especially like when it comes to like Guatemalas or Guatemalans or Honduras and stuff like that. Yeah, they're real isolated. They like to isolate themselves from everybody else. They're not like Puerto Ricans or Dominicans where we just talk to everybody, you know, like
God.
You know? We don't care, we talk to anybody. So but they're not like that. So I need brothers from those tribes to like, you know, really. Plus, the language barrier is different from Puerto
Rico. There is a language barrier.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? The language holds a barrier where I might say, like, there was a lady from Guatemala when I was in Virginia, and my wife said, quiere picocho. And she looked at my wife like what? And my wife was like, what, you want cake? And the girl was like, that's not how you say cake. That's down there. That's that private word down there. Like, whoa, you know what I'm saying? Like, we ain't know that. We Puerto Rican. We don't speak proper Spanish, bro.
Right.
But you know,
God.
So that's the language barrier that I'm talking about. And we need I need brothers that could spit it properly. So, and you know, and the work could be done, man.
Con, you know, we had we got a place here in Tampa. It's called Little Mexico. And you know, we've been teaching there a lot, you know. It's been a minute since we've gone back, but predominantly we teach there. So we had a couple hecklers, you know, Issachar brothers then in the corner, they drunk, they drinking, okay. They see us teaching, we rebuking the hell out of them. And you know, they giving it to us. They making fun of us, and you know, they're calling us names, and you know, I'm gonna straight up, you with me, you're gonna have to get it. You know what I'm saying?
And
I was giving it to them, and you know, it was kind of that I had to match them. You know what I'm saying?
I had to match the energy.
You know, I don't know what they were saying to me, but I can't remember right now, but. I pissed them off. You know what I'm saying? You have to get a certain point where you have to piss Issachar off. You know what I'm saying? But you're right. You have to, like, the dialect, you have to, you know, kind of, you know, finesse it necessarily, yeah. You know, yeah. Where you kind of in between. A lot right. of brothers confuse me, you know, as either Ephraim or Manasseh mm-hmm. When they're speaking to me. But I'll switch it up, you know, because I could actually speak, you know, like an Argentinian off the bat, like I'm speaking to my father or whatever. Che is a Hebrew word, not only Che, but it's actually a native word meaning people, mm. you know. So when we say Che, it's actually native, you know, it's not, you know, not native, you know, it's
right.
From there. So, but to us, it means like, hey, or people or them, or, you know, hey, what's going on? Or Che, you know, whatever, you know, so it means a lot to us. And then vos, like you, right. And in Mexico, they say the same thing. They'll say vos, right. Or we'll say vos too. Right. Whereas saying, you know, you, right. Well, tu, not tu. We don't say tu. What we say.
That's what we say.
Right. We say vos, right? So does Mexico. So I learned how to kind of switch it where I'll be like, okay, if I'm talking to a Mexican, I know to kind of switch it up from here, you know? Colombia is a little bit more, how can I say, a little bit more complicated, you know? Cause they got their own whole language.
They sound aggressive when they speak too.
Right.
They pronounce their words aggressively.
Right.
It's weird, man. I don't know. Like, that's how I know this language is not ours.
Right.
I'll be honest with
you. Faster language, man.
Yeah. It's the slave language. Again, too, that's prophecy of Judges. I forgot what book in Judges was it where Ephraim couldn't pronounce a word, and because Shebole, I think the name was, and we couldn't pronounce it, and so because we couldn't pronounce it, we got bodied on the spot by the other tribes. You know, so that's kind of like
prophecy,
right? It's prophecy, man. the language barrier, man. We all speak it same language, but we speak it differently,
right?
And you know, that's just us, I guess. But one day, we'll be speaking that native tongue all together, right. You know, in unison, you know what I'm saying? So
That's right. Yep, that's Zephaniah 3:9.
There you go.
That's us speaking the same language that Yahawashi spoke to Saul, man, you know?
Right.
And that's that our ancient tongue, man. Yahawah willing, man, we all see that day, but it's time for us to wake up, Israel, man. You know, we're going to start doing a lot of things, you know, to start really focusing on the Northern Kingdom.
We have to.
And brother, I'm going to call on you, brother. I'm going to tell you that. I'm going to call on you, bro.
Hey.
We're going to do some things, man.
Let's do some things, man. I've been trying to reach out. There's a YouTube page. It's called, I don't care about giving anybody a plug. It's called House of Joseph, where it's a bunch of Ephraimites and others. But,
King Ecclesiastes.
Yeah.
He was in Puerto Rico with us.
Yeah, so you know, I look at it like somebody like me connecting with you, we connecting with them, us connecting with others. You see what I'm saying? And it brings like this whole Northern Kingdom unification. Now, we're not forgetting about Judah and Benjamin and
Levi.
You know, of course, we understand. But it's time for Northern Kingdom to shine.
That's right.
And come to the light. You see what I'm saying? Because right. what's the Messiah's goal was to bring the lost tribes to the light, right?
That's right.
And be a light to the lost tribes. So we need to be a light to the lost tribes, which is us Northern Kingdomers. That's my goal. Back in the days, I got when I was in a camp, I kind of got rebuked for saying that my goal was going to be Northern Kingdom. Ever since then, that's been my goal. You know what I'm saying? Like, thank you for rebuking me, but your rebuke is worthless because I'm about my people. So I don't care what you say. I love I love Judah, and I spent the last 6 years. This is no lie. I spent the last 6 years waking up Judah.
Right.
I would struggle and fight and argue with Judah, mainly at my job. I don't know if you remember. I remember one time I put a post and I said, I don't care if I get fired. And you was like, damn, brother ain't using the spirit. He ain't using that wisdom properly. And I remember my remark was, somebody got to be a martyr. You see what I'm saying? Because it's like, all right, cool. I'm surrounded by Judah. Because at the time I was surrounded by Judah so much that I'm like, I need to wake somebody up. And if this is the only tribe that's around me, then I'm going to wake them up.
Right.
I used to hold camp at work. It would be break time. I'm standing out there by the tree. I remember in the shade and everybody's outside and I'm talking real loud and I'm kicking in. And I'm like, yo, you know, you Israelite. It is what it is, man. But that was the whole 6 years, brother. So now it's time that Northern Kingdom, man. I gotta push for Northern Kingdom, and whatever it takes, man. Whatever it takes.
Hey, man. Well, that's my mission as well, Ak. And I know there's a lot of brothers who are gonna be listening to this. That's their mission as well. As a matter of fact, King Ecclesiastes, I'm gonna connect y'all.
I hit him up on his channel.
Okay, Khan.
I hit him up.
He's a solid brother. You know, labor with him, so. Yeah, man. I mean, this is what we need to be doing. And
I'm honestly, Salaki. I want to take a time where we go all meet up and all. So it's like a unity camp of Northern Kingdom.
Khan, you know, we were talking about doing that last year.
Man, what? Come on.
Yeah, we were talking about doing that last year. Yeah, but we were planning on doing it. Central Florida was going to be the hub. We were just calling everybody in, and sure thing, this whole, you know, virus thing happened. It got shut down. I mean, literally, we had a location and everything. We had brothers that agreed to it and everything. So as things start opening up, let's put it together, man.
Let's Let's you know,
we can do that.
Start planning and start looking up things.
Absolutely.
I want to just say that the breakdown that you gave, it was short but powerful. That's my method, short and powerful. I learned that from my favorite rap group.
Who that?
Wu-Tang.
Ah, God.
They got like 8 men. And they got to all fit each other in and just
right. God.
3 minutes. So they keep it short but powerful. You know what I'm saying? So that's been my motto for a while.
I've always been like that too. To the point.
To the point. Yeah, you're right. To the point. So I appreciate you coming on here.
Yeah, man. The water, you know, and all praise
to the Most High. All praise to the Most High. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, man. Stay up, stay connected. And, like I said, for everybody watching, man, thank you for tuning in. And for those that watch later on, thank you for tuning in too. I hope you learned something. Spread the word. Wake people up, man. All right, brother.
Kamakan, Shalom, Yasharala. Much love to y'all, man. The water, Yasuf. Appreciate you, King. Y'all, right. Barakatam to y'all family. Shalom.
Shalom, brother.